traffic and people got to give you a conference and sit down with you. And from what, I have not read the packet, but I've already heard a lot of misinformation that I can prove you is totally false. Rhode Island, under decriminalization, Galleria went down 40%, Rick went down 30% from the whole state during that time. We also hear that most women are trafficked in a, we know 98% of the sex industry are consenting adults that choose to do sex work because it's the best option for them. Dr. Ryan has met hundreds of consensual adult sex workers. I just interviewed 1,138, we did a nationwide survey. We talked last time about the survey we did in Rhode Island, the 62 women, where 24% of them agreed for being robbed, raped, or assaulted by police officers. We talked about Celeste Gabe out in California, where 30 police officers exploited her. Since then, the city of Oakland has paid her $1 million, and those officers had a secret award ceremony, and they got an award. So we just did a 145-question survey on over 1,100 sex workers. We asked them about when they entered, what were they victims, what their circumstances, condom use and testing, so much. This is the biggest lump of data on U.S. sex workers anyone has ever conducted. And I want to point out that I've spoken at URI before. Donna Hughes was invited to hear me speak. She did not show up. She's not here today. She will not sit with a sex worker and have a conversation. She has a degree in animal genetics. When she went around and interviewed the spa women, she doesn't tell you what she asked them or what they replied. She writes this narrative that they're bringing busloads of men into the spas and the women have to share their money with the towel boy. There's no factual evidence. There's no data in her. It is all her opinion. What we have is data from actual sex workers. We know there's millions of sex workers. Actually, I've been to 78 labor conferences, and we presented the findings in Rhode Island at UALE Boston Labor Conference in 2017. And they're writing a chapter in their book, or they're publishing. They do recognize sex workers as labor. Strippers, dominatrix, cam workers, porn performers, escorts, they're all sex workers. Some of those jobs are legal, and some of them aren't. To deny that you want to call us prostituted women and that we refuse to acknowledge that I make the labor of erotic labor and I am a sex worker is an insult, and it's a way to systematically suppress people. But I want to talk a little bit more about the trafficking narrative. That we're spending $1 billion a year just to create awareness. And as long as we keep selling this narrative that evil men with dark skin are trying to pimp out young white girls, we never have to talk about economic inequality, systematic oppression, violence, the 320 unlicensed foster homes in Rhode Island, the 4 children that have died in Rhode Island State here this year, or the man that worked at a group home in Rhode Island just a few weeks ago for 30 years who used a state van to pimp a teenager out. And of course, it wasn't called sex trafficking then. 97% of all sexual abuse on children happens by someone the child knows and not through prostitution. I can't remember which of the two victims you spoke of, but I've spoken to one of them on Facebook. She told me that she was trafficked at age 13, and I asked her, why didn't you dial 911? Why didn't you tell someone? Why didn't you go to the police? And you know what she told me? Because the police were the customers. And she now runs a trafficking website. If you go to her website, she's asking for donations, and the only resource she has is the number to Polaris Project. Now, I'm sure in your package they say things like Polaris Project, which is the And I'm sure you have numbers in your packet that the average age is 13 and there's 300,000. Maybe you can take that back, because we can fund them with the real debt. Out of the 1,100 people we've interviewed, the average age of entry was 21. We always assumed it was 17 to 25. So the average age is not 13. We also know an increase of 18 and 19-year-olds are now being charged with sex trafficking, because when a sex worker works alone, it's a misdemeanor. If you give me a ride to Walmart or to a hotel, you become a panderer, promoter, and you become a major felon, and that is what they're labeling as traffickers. These are third-party support staff. A lot of sex workers have people that screen their calls, book their appointments, their flights, their hotels, and all of that. In Rhode Island, police got an award in 2016 for their kindness in community policing and shutting down 15 Asian massage parlors. And they lied to the public and said multi-million dollar sex trafficking operations. In fact, they were small groups of immigrant in their 40s or 50s who all were deported. So this did not help them. Now, another thing we hear in the media from the police and the trafficking is all the women that were rescued, aka rescued, were offered all these wonderful services. And you know what services they were offered? A bed in a public shelter. No one is going to pay their rent, feed their children, pay their car insurance, pay their debts. No one's going to give them a subsidized housing, a job that pays a living wage. As long as we don't talk about that, no one can live on $8 to $10 an hour. And a huge majority of these women are in their 30s, 40s, and 50s, and they're single parents. So this analogy of policing adults does not protect our children. There's better ways to protect the children. And right now, this one 18-year-old in Ohio was arrested 2 weeks after her 18th birthday. She was just sentenced to 6 years in prison. She was under the control of a pimp. She had a Facebook conversation with another minor. They never even met. And they charged her with sex trafficking. And she's sitting in prison for 6 years, and she's a victim. The Nordic model. Let's talk about the Nordic model. But why should we make all the clients? Well, let me tell you. I've got clients that are in the military.
So I'm not sure that all my colleagues, I know that those of us who attended the